Time for the peak. I'm using 1, 2, 4. Now, I'd already put the outline around it. And as you know, folks, the red doesn't like anything underneath it. I put a little bit of pink in there, but that will weaken this colour as it goes on. You'll see that in a minute, especially when I blend it. The pink will blend into the 1, 2, 4. I'm being a little bit cautious and careful because red, if it goes over the edge there, it will. I really wanted to keep that white, that bit there. I put white on, a white dot on originally. Yes, if red goes over the top, although you could erase it, it will leave, it will like stain the paper. Okay, so it's better to be accurate. That's pretty good. Right, now having done that, I'm going to use the colour shaper, the pointed one. Now you see what I mean, that pink underneath that has weakened that, which is exactly what I was looking for. But when you come down here, it will be the raw colour, but we've got to push it into the paper. That's pretty good. I'm pleased with that. See, it's giving that a little bit of. And just to make sure that that is weak, I'm going to put the pink back on. This is 1, 3, 2. Back in. Just to make it just that little bit more blended. It's only just there. That's the only area. This one is a little bit more. Now another colour I have, which I've used already in here, is the 226. 226 is just a tiny bit darker, but not much. But it will go with this one quite well, the 124. So we'll put the 226 on. It just adds another tone to it. Now before I blend that, what I want to do is add yet another, and this is 193. It's a little bit darker. It's going on very well, and the reason it's going on well is because I blended it. Now we do need a darker colour, and the only colour I can think of is the black. Now you've got to be careful here. Now that beak there, is that's the. Now it's not very obvious, so I'm going to follow with my guideline here. Darken it just a little more like that. This is also dark here. Now you've got to be very careful with this. When you do it, you don't put too much pressure on it. Otherwise you'll never get it off. Well, you will. You'll have to rub it all out. You can imagine that's going to be pretty horrendous. Now just there, I also want some dark. And then back in with the colour shaper, and with luck we will have a nice tone which we have. Now, had I put that black on strong, that would have been very, it would have spread out. But as it happens, it's great. And I think what I'll do is I'll go back in with the original colour, 124, and just revitalise it, a bit like a little bit of blue. But I've got a real rich tone. There you go. Brilliant.